Hey, are you in the finance function of your organization, or you're just working for a financial services organization and you're just spending so much time copying and pasting data? It's taking you so long and you know there's a better way. You're gonna wanna stick around because in this video, I'm gonna show you the tool you need to know in order to optimize your workday. Hey, let me introduce you to someone. She's called Jane the accountant. Hey Jane, how you doing?
Hey, hello, yeah, nice.
She's the life of the office. Everyone loves Jane, hey? And she is an accountant based in the finance department of our organization, right? She has the responsibility to produce routine management information for her business. Now, this management information, otherwise known as MI, is crucial for allowing decision makers to understand how the business is performing. Right? So one such MI report focuses on illustrating business sales for the previous month. Let's take a moment, shall we, to see how this process is typically undertaken by people within a finance function or financial service organizations with and without the tool that you need to know. That's called Alteryx. Hey, let's have a look. Right? So this is the traditional manual method. So what we're going to be doing is building a report. This report goes ahead and highlights the sales that our customers are making in our business from the previous month to the current month. Right? We need to compare the two to one another. Right? So we've got system A. It's called the customer CRM system. Right? So this might be your Salesforce instance, for example. What we're going to do, or Jane much rather, is going to come in. She's got system B here as well. That's a transactional database. Hey? So you've got two separate systems going on here. What Jane needs to do, she's coming in the morning, 9 o'clock, had a little bit of a coffee, right, it's 10 past now, comes into system A, punching in her credentials in the front end of the system, right? She's going ahead and finding the view of the data that she's interested in getting out. Okay, there we go, gonna do file, export to Excel. Now we've got a variety of files sat within her downloads folder. She's going into system B, right, going back into that front end, punching in her credentials, then find the view of data she's interested in there, right, going to apply the right filters, all that sort of stuff, make sure it's the current month, the previous month, export that down via an Excel file into a downloads folder as well. So now she's got a load of files that sat within that downloads folder, hey? She's going to have to open them both up and copy them into the same Excel workbook, therefore the data is within the same file. Once it's in with the same file, what she can do is go ahead and cleanse it up, right? There's a little bit of cleansing. Doesn't come out to the system exactly how I need it every single time. Pretty good. But there's a little element, maybe 5 to 10 minutes to clean some things up. But she knows what she's doing. She's done this week in, week out for many years, hey? Right, next, what she's gonna have to do is pivot and sum up that data, hey? So we've got the transaction data from system B. That needs to be summed up for each individual customer, so therefore I can join this transactional data, or much rather chain, can join them together between the two systems, hey? Once that's been done, then she's gonna have to attempt to join the data sets together. So we all know about, if you're in Excel anyway, hey, the VLOOKUP formula. I've done it a few times, I just can't get the hang of it sometimes, hey? Jane tries it, hash value, hash NA, hash name comes through. Oh my goodness, she's confused, doesn't know what's going on. She's going on Stack Overflow forums to try and figure out what the issue is, trying to debug the error. Oh goodness, so tell you what, eventually she gets there after maybe about half an hour smashing her head against her table, right? She ends up splitting the data out depending on which department needs to take a look at the data. And then she's gonna go ahead and name the files accordingly. So right, what's today's date? Make sure I prefix that on the file name and then go ahead and get that out into a variety of different reports, and now she's done. For now, right? Because when it starts to go the next week, the next month, the next reporting period, whenever that is, hey, she's going back, look at that, to square number one. She's going all the way back to the start, going into system A, going to system B, exporting the data, and the cycle repeats itself. Maybe I'm talking to a lot of you out there. Does this sound familiar? I bet it does. In my experience, this is still how people operate in their businesses within this year, right? Now, there is a better way, and you know it in your heart, there's a better way, right? This is not scalable. How can we add more customers to our business without increasing our headcount and making sure everyone's not stressed, making sure you keep that work-life balance within your personal lives, hey? So let's have a look at the alternative method. This is the new innovative Alteryx method, hey? Have a look at this. So we've still got system A, that hasn't changed, right? We've still got system B, that's still there. We're not changing that source data whatsoever. What we're doing is changing the processing of that data, right? So Jane comes in, she's configured her Alteryx workflow. Alteryx is an automated data preparation, blend, and analysis tool. If you want to learn more about that tool, I've got a video specifically on that subject where I dive deep into what Alteryx is. You're going to want to watch that. Anyway, so Alteryx comes in, we automatically read that data into the program. Alteryx then goes ahead, inputs, cleanse, joins, transforms that data. Again, we're not innovating anything new here. Everything that Jane has been doing in that previous manual method is just being repeated here in Alteryx. Nothing new, we're just whizzing through in a fraction of the time, right? Once that's done here in Alteryx, Jane comes in, right? She's popping open Alteryx. She's gonna press the run button. There you go, she's selected it. And there we go, we have the automatically, you're gonna output all the same files in the format that's needed for the rest of the business and the stakeholders and the management who wanna see that management information, right? So now it's done. And I tell you what, Jane falls in love with Alteryx. Oh my goodness, give me so much time back in my day. I can do things that I didn't think I had the time for. Those projects have been sat side a desk. You know what? I've now got their time and attention to go ahead and focus on that. She falls in love with Alteryx and so does the entire business. So let's have a quick look at what Jane has put together in Alteryx and you can see it in action for yourself. So this is the Alteryx workflow that Jane has gone ahead and created. Now she's done this herself, right? I want to emphasize that fact that Alteryx is a tool that doesn't take away from your workload. No. What Alteryx does, it gives you the power to go ahead and build these solutions for yourselves, right? Jane, the accountant herself, built this very solution you're taking a look at. Alteryx is unique in the way that it's no code. Right, yeah, you heard it, no code, because it allows technology people as well as line of business people to interact with the tool so they can build these automated solutions themselves. I'll tell you what, if you think this is complicated, don't worry about it. If you can do a VLOOKUP in Excel, you're overqualified, I'll tell you that. Right, so this is the workflow that Jane's built. And again, that process could have taken her, what, half an hour, 45 minutes, maybe up towards an hour if she's stuck on that VLOOKUP expression, hey, to get the errors and things like that. Again, it doesn't take very long. It's not too big of a deal every week or every month, but have a look at this. I'm gonna go ahead and execute this process. I've run that workflow, exactly the same steps gone on. Here's our system A, here's our system B, bringing it in, all that sort of stuff. Zoom on in on this. You see that? 0.8 seconds. Isn't that fantastic? We just whizzed through that process. Rather than taking an hour, it takes not even a second now to get Jane's data out the system, and then she can continue to use it however she sees fit. She's given her the time back to do whatever she wants within her day. All right, so that's given you a flavor of what Alteryx is, and hopefully you understand the value it can bring to you as a user within the finance function. So we've got many, many clients that we work with, hundreds in fact, and a lot of them are within the financial services sector. So one such client actually utilized Alteryx, as we've just seen here, to create financial statements for their clients. So every single quarter, they got hundreds of clients need to produce financial statements for. Now they charge those clients a fixed fee every single quarter. So you can imagine what value that's gonna bring back to the organization if we trim down that time it takes to create the financial statements from hours to minutes. That's right, it takes minutes now for a client of ours to go ahead and create hundreds of financial statements every single quarter because we've enabled their finance function to utilize a tool such as Alteryx, and now they click of a button, it whizzes on through. Isn't that fantastic? And you can see then the margin that you're getting as a financial organization on that fixed fee is gonna increase dramatically, therefore giving you a lot of value. So as you've seen here, we've just demonstrated the tool Alteryx. It's phenomenal. You're gonna wanna get your hands on it. If you do, have a look in the description down below. You're gonna see a link to connect to a 30-day free trial of Alteryx, and you can go ahead and play around the tool yourself, see if it's for you, all right? Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions at all. We always answer those questions. And as you believe it, Alteryx is only step one on a grander data-driven journey, right? Step number one is making sure you've got all of these processes, these manual, slow, error-prone processes, automated and watertight, and in the rig out with a tool such as Alteryx we just talked about. Step number one of four, would you believe? You wanna know all those four distinct stages and data maturity, you're gonna wanna check out this video right here, where I'll go into detail on precisely what those four stages are and how you can take your organization from step number one to data-driven.